Hey guys, I got this new RC car from Larlo for review, and then I modified it with FPV setup and long range radio system. So in this video I will share with you my experience and thought about this cool 114 scale brushless RC buggy. Let's find out what inside the box. I got this accessory kit. There are many parts there. We'll see what inside later. It's RTR, so it comes with its own gun style RC controller or radio transmitter. And this car looks cool with soft rubber tires, metal drive shafts, dog bone and metal steering rod, adjustable suspensions and carbon chassis, and also has roller wheels on the rear bumper. Let's see what's inside. Larlo claims it can reach 80 km per hour or about 50 miles per hour with 2S battery. Here the brushless motor, it's 2847 3200 kV. The steering rod looks rigid and strong. The 45M brushless ESC has integrated small fan. It can support 3S battery too. And this is the antenna. In this model, the ESC and receivers are merged together into one unit. All suspension are adjustable, and also there's oil inside this tube. You can rotate the ring to adjust it. Now it's on the surface setting. All metal connection on the wheel except this lower control arm is made out of hard plastic. Its wing spoiler is made out of flexible yet durable material, so it's crash proof. And here are what inside the accessory kit. It's a manual book, says it can reach 100 km per hour speed or about 60 miles per hour with 3S battery. Here's some nuts and washer for the wheels. This is an additional practice bumper. Very useful to familiarize to control this car because it's very fast. You need more protection for the front suspension. And also spare part for the wheel, it's slower control arm. And this is 2S 2800 mAh LiPo battery. It's small and compact, fit perfectly inside the chassis. Also comes with a USB charger. I didn't know 2S LiPo can be charged with USB, nice. So this RC car is really a complete kit. Buy this and you will have all what you need to operate this car inside the box with just about $170, because now it's on sale. The original price is $200. Some tools and car body lock pins. Wow, also with metal dog bone spare parts. Nice, you got many spare parts for this and can enjoy this RC car for a long time. And here gun style radio transmitter like other RC car controller. Unlike the car itself, the controller looks less expensive, but with all functionality like throttle and steering trimmer, reverse switch and steering rate. The trigger is quite soft to press. It uses 3 pieces of AA batteries. How to turn on this RC car is simple. First, plug the fully charged battery to the ESC. And then turn on the transmitter or controller. You can see here the green light is flashing. And then push the button on the ESC here. Push and hold until it sounds like this. Now the controller is already connected with the RC car. The green light is constant. You can see the mini fan blade is spinning here. How to turn off is just backward. press the button until the fan is stopped, unplug the battery, and finally turn off the transmitter. Before testing outside, I recommend you to adjust the throttle first, especially for a beginner like my son here. I tell him to set the throttle trimmer to the lowest point to see what it goes. Okay, that's the full throttle looks like. Pretty useful for learning to drive. And now the steering rate. This is the lowest point. And then try it full point. And this is how it goes. Finally, for my son and me, we prefer to set all medium on the center. The car can still move slow but also fast, but not too fast. You can see here, I already installed the practice bumper. If you want to make the car jumping on a ramp or a bump like this, I suggest you to detach the practice bumper because it often causes the car to cartwheeling like this. I like to hold the trigger like this instead of this, because it's more precise on the throttle. You can trim the steering if your car is not driving straight, but sometimes it's quite hard to set the correct trim using knob potentio like this, but not that hard. I think you'll manage. Also better if the transmitter have expo function on the steering for more smoother steering, but maybe it will make it more expensive. I think the RTR like this is quite good move for beginner customers. In my Wi-Fi crowded neighborhood, it can only reach about 60 to 70 meters range depending on the battery juice. For beginners, that's enough range to enjoy driving, but maybe cannot reach maximum speed. So the solution is to drive it on Wi-Fi free environment. Okay, to be able to drive this RC car far away with my FPV setup, I need to replace the RC system including the receiver. But unfortunately, Larlo made the AESC and receiver merge together. I think it would be very cool if they separate the AESC from receiver, just like a hobby RC car should be. So I need to add new brushless AESC. Unfortunately, I only have brush RC car AESC. But I have this brushless boat AESC that I use on my yachts. I think it can be used. It's 50mm AESC and of course it also waterproof. Oh yes, I forgot to mention that all Larlo RC car electronic components are all waterproof. So you can freely drive the RC car on puddle or wet grass. And then I use this micro long range express LRS receiver from Beta FPV. So I can control it with my jumper T16, with also equipped with Beta FPV Express LRS transmitter module. And here I use 600 milliwatt VTX. I forgot the brand, maybe like IOMWE, I don't know. And use this RunCam 2 as an FPV camera and recorder. This RC setup made this RC buggy can reach 200 meters or more. Me and my son really have fun enjoying this RC car in the last couple of days. The motor power, the suspension, and the durability are amazing. Also, the number of the spare parts included on the box is making this product worth to buy. My son prefer the gun controller than my jumper T16, but for FPV driving, he prefer the jumper T16 because with expo function, the steering become more precise and smooth. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Yesterday I just taxi test this built in progress B2 Spirit RC plane. I hope it can finish soon and upload the build video. See you again in the next episode.